Hi, Phil Janke here again, and welcome to another installment of my music history podcast. Today, I will be discussing producer-engineer Mark Flood Ellis. Mark Ellis, or Flood as he was referred to, gave bands their signature sound using creative recording techniques. He was known for perfecting the ability to blend synthetic and organic elements. With these techniques, Flood was able to revolutionize the alternative rock genre of the late 80s with bands such as Depeche Mode and U2. Flood was fortunate enough to work with Brian Eno on the YouTube album, The Joshua Tree. The song, Still Haven't Found What I'm Looking For, is a great example of Flood's excellent engineering skills coupled with the genius of Brian Eno. The song is very open and ambient with a real sense of space and the environment you are in. Typically, recording this way was a strange request at the time. Flood's albums would typically come out perfect and pristine. The sound he created were mysterious, yet it seemed to be everywhere at the same time. This sound influenced bands of today to record like that, such as 30 Seconds to Mars. Flood worked on their album, This Is War, the album that would almost mimic the sounds of the 80s bands Flood worked with, but with the added chants from choral groups. Here's an example of the 30 Seconds to Mars album, This Is War, with the song Kings and Queens. As you can tell, it is obvious that Mark Flood Ellis is a very innovative producer slash engineer. His style of recording has influenced bands to bring out the best studio albums that they possibly can. The music industry would all sound the same if it was not for innovators like Flood to open doors to new recording techniques used by the bands of the 60s and 70s with producers slash engineers like Brian Eno and Phil Spector. Even though I'm not a diehard U2, Depeche Mode, or 30 Seconds to Mars fan, I still have complete appreciation for their work and their recording styles. Understanding the complexity of engineering that went into these albums opened my mind to new ways to record. Please join me next week when my guests will be Michael Jackson and Amy Winehouse. This has been Phil Janke's Music History Podcast. Reach out, touch faith.